Hi everyone, I'm Shaylin here with Reedsy. Today I'm going to be talking about 8 fundamental marketing tips. Now we have done a few videos on marketing before and I will leave a link to all of our previous marketing videos as well as some marketing blog posts and courses in the description. Since marketing is such an important part of the publishing process, you can write the most amazing book of all time, but if you don't market it well, readers aren't going to know about it, therefore they're not going to be able to buy it and read it. Essentially, marketing your book is communicating to other people why they should buy your book and giving them easy ways to do so. Here are some fundamental tips to get you started. Step number one is to do your market research. Now, it can be weird to frame something that you might see as purely creative, like you're writing, into a business, but for the marketing stage of your book, you kind of have to do so. You can't market your book to everyone, so you need to identify a more specific target audience. Research which books are bestsellers in your genre. What do these books have in common in terms of marketing? So their titles, their covers, their descriptions. Try to identify if you're writing in a nicher genre where you might be able to stand out more. Whereas if you're writing in a broader genre, it might be more oversaturated with New York Times bestsellers. You also want to research your readers. What are the average demographics of readers in your genre? What's their income and how much do they expect to pay for a book? Books in different genres and categories have different average price points. How quickly do they read? How many books does a reader in this genre tend to read per year? What are some of their common interests? You're trying to create your ideal reader, a hypothetical person who is most likely to pick up and love your book. So when you make marketing decisions, you want to think about how you can reach this specific person, since this person is like a stand-in for your overall target audience. We've got an entire course on finding target readers, so I will leave a link to that in the description. Once you know your target audience, you have to make sure that you have the right product for your market. Your book needs to either match or exceed the expectations of your readers. And different genres have different rules and expectations regarding what sells best. Study the successful books in your genre and see how your book compares in terms of tone and style, structure, character trope, and how dense the writing and information is. Now, if you're way off the mark, you may want to adjust, or if you feel like you don't want to change your book, it might be that you've incorrectly identified your genres or subgenres, so take another look at genre classifications. There might be a genre that better describes and suits what you're going for. The next step is to make it look pretty. Book design is such an important part of marketing. You'll probably hear this over and over the more you research marketing, but your cover really is one of your most important marketing tools. Because let's be honest, people do judge books by their covers. You're probably not that likely to pick up an ugly book you've never heard of off the shelf. But if you're browsing through a bookstore and you see a beautiful cover that even if you've never heard of the book, you might pick it up just because it's really beautiful. The monkey brain kicks in and we like shiny things. A good cover needs to be eye-catching, look good as a thumbnail as well as in full size, and send the proper messages about your book. If you design a cover that doesn't match your genre, you'll send the wrong signal and you won't attract the right readers. Let's try a little quiz right now. What genre is this book in? Is it A, fantasy, B, thriller, C, romance, or D, a cookbook? What if I told you that this was a fantasy book? You'd be pretty surprised, right? I doubt many people who exclusively read fantasy are going to gravitate towards this book because nothing about this book screams fantasy. Therefore, if you were to design a fantasy cover that looks like this, you're gonna get a lot of romance readers picking up your book and none of the readers in your actual target audience. Now, of course, this is actually a romance novel, so if you said C, you were correct. So if you're writing a genre other than romance and your cover looks like this, you're probably off the mark and you're not going to draw in the right readers. Now, the next step is to establish your web presence. To have any kind of visibility, you'll need to have a social media presence and you really can't start too early with this. It takes a long time to build a platform, so you might as well start now. We do have a video on social media for writers, so I will leave a link to that if you're just getting started, but here are some fundamentals to keep in mind. First of all is your website, which we've actually also got a video on that you can check out. Your website is like the central hub for your online platform. It's the first place people are going to go when they Google you. Make sure it's clean and easy to navigate, so people can easily find an about section, easy ways to contact you, links to your social platforms, and, very importantly, links to where your book can be purchased or pre-ordered. Keep it up to date, and if you're not a master web designer, keeping it clean and simple is probably going to be better than trying to do something really complicated and fancy that you don't know how to do and it just looking cluttered. You also want to set up a mailing list. Mailing lists are crucial because they give you a direct link to your reader's inbox. I'll leave a link to our course on mailing lists, but one of the most important things to keep in mind is to have a reader magnet. Basically, this is an incentive you give people to sign up for your mailing list. It's something that you offer for free to new subscribers, such as a bonus short story or novella, a whole book from your backlist, a workbook. Whatever it is, it should be free and related to the content of the book that you are marketing. Next is to learn the secrets of Amazon. Amazon is a publishing kingpin, so even if you sell across multiple platforms, most of your sales will come from Amazon. Learn how to use it and you can gain a lot of visibility and a lot of sales as a result. If you set this up smartly, Amazon will actually start doing a lot of the marketing legwork for you by automatically suggesting your book to readers without you having to actively do anything. Start by building your book page. You need an optimized book description that will also hook readers' attention. We've got an entire video on this, so I'll leave a link to that in the description. You also want to pay attention to categories and keywords. You want to use categories that are in that sweet spot between too obscure that no one is looking at them and so popular that they're oversaturated by bestsellers. You can also consider KDP Select. Once again, we've got an entire video on deciding whether KDP Select is right for you, but essentially it's a program where you grant Amazon 90-day exclusivity in exchange for some bonus marketing perks that can give you more visibility on the Amazon platform. You also want to customize your author page with a bio and a link to your mailing list, as well as set up pre-orders. Start strong by marketing before your book's release date. You can also use it as a chance to adjust your categories, keywords, and book description before the launch date. The next step is advertising. Now, advertising is a you have to spend money to make money case, and there are lots of advertising options, so you'll need to familiarize yourself with what works, and there will probably be some trial and error involved. Probably the best options will be Amazon and Facebook ads. Amazon ads can appear on the product page for other books, as well as in the search results for people browsing. This is a good way to reach people who are already looking to spend money on books since they're already on Amazon. Facebook ads, on the other hand, can be used to advertise your book, or they can be used to advertise your mailing list by promoting your reader magnet. You can also run several at once, targeting different readers to see what works best. There's a lot to cover in regards to ads, so once again, I'll leave links to courses on Facebook and Amazon ads in the description. The next step is to grow your reader base. Once you have a reader base, you want to build on that. Word of mouth is actually a really powerful marketing tool. Engage with your audience on social media and be open and genuine. Find ways for people to interact with you by posting polls, questions, challenges, running a giveaway, starting discussions, really whatever. You also want to give your readers chances not only to interact with you, but also with each other to build a greater sense of community. More dedicated readers might also want to form your street team, a smaller group of people who can help you promote your book leading up to its launch. These readers leave early reviews of your book and help raise awareness about your book by posting about it on their blog or social platforms. Find a street team and give them perks for being involved in order to reach more people and gain visibility for your book. We've got a video on planning a successful book launch, so I'll leave a link to that in the description and in the cards. Finally, the last step is to scale it up. Once you've had success with all of these techniques, you can start taking them to the next level. If you've had early success and are getting a lot of sales, don't sit back. Instead, make the most of it. Stay up to date on new marketing strategies and don't be afraid to experiment and try something new. So those are some fundamental tips for marketing a book. And again, I've left a ton of resources since this is such a vast topic that you can check out in the description. Thanks so much for watching. Remember to subscribe and turn on notifications so you don't miss any new videos from us. We've got new writing, editing, and publishing tips every Tuesday and Friday. Until next time.